succeed even today. Yes, we will. What we have today, and told the Union Home Minister that if you don't stop this sort of witch-hunting that is taking place, we cannot believe, the country cannot believe. Today the Foreign Secretary of India is from our university. Ambassadors, the chief are working in the administration that are students of this university. And these sort of elements have always existed, they will always exist, but they cannot stop them from crossing the border. So that is something we once again have to prove today. Therefore, we have told the Union Home Minister that if there is any violation of the Indian law, if there is any violation of the Indian law, in accordance to the law, you can take action. But on the name of that, in the pretext of that, coming down on the whole university to try and destroy this institution, which has contributed the most for building modern India in the last 4 decades, that is something we will not accept. That is something this country will not allow. We will have our differences of opinions. Yes, all those who opposed me in this campus when I stood for elections, all those I opposed when they stood for elections, they are all there in various positions which are building our modern India today. A secular democratic India. A secular democratic India that has always rejected these sort of ideas that want to impose a very inclusive unilateral concept of their own Hindu Rashtra that they want to bring in here. So yes, it's a democratic battle. We have also said, I'm just coming from meeting the Chief Minister of Delhi. We have asked the Chief Minister of Delhi, because he has the jurisdiction, and unfortunately he alone has the jurisdiction, to order a magisterial inquiry into the authenticity of all the evidence that the government is now producing to ensure, to establish whether there is any fact of what they are saying. The Delhi Chief Minister has assured us that yes, this government will order a magisterial inquiry, and through which the authenticity of the evidence that is being provided by the government will be examined and will be questioned. We will take up this issue also naturally in the parliament when it comes here. But please remember one thing. I cannot for one believe, and I don't think most of India can never believe, that the students of JNU, the teachers of JNU, the Kalkaris of JNU, any one of them can be anti-national and We were proud when my generation was here in this campus, when all these institutions were being built up. The many teachers of my time who are here today, there are many teachers who have now become teachers and deans who are my classmates. They are all here today. Together we built this university. And we built it with what principles? What sentiments? Yes, there was a time then. Students in very, very, very important colleges. Let's take one instance in Assam. We had a student called Jiranjan Talukdar in Assam. He was killed by the extremist, anti-Indian extremists. For a month his body could not be found. His body was later found, cut into pieces, robbed in a well by anti-Indian terrorists and extremists. What was the slogan that we gave in JNU then? That we belong to a student community, we belong to the JNU, which prides in the fact that A student can be cut into pieces, but we will not allow my country to be cut into pieces. That is the foundation. That is the foundation on which this university was built. This university was built on the basis of a vision. Of a vision of Jawaharlal Nehru, whom they are all opposing now, shouting the slogans. That vision, which says a university stands for tolerance, a university stands for humanism, a university stands for an adventure of ideas. And we would like this government to remember the last sentence of that quotation. When all is well with the universities, then all is well with the country. If today you are trying to use this as an excuse to crack down on JNU and destroy its culture, its academic potential and the contributions it has made, you are aiming for the destruction of the modern secular democratic republic of India, and that won't be allowed. And that will not be allowed. So therefore, we will pursue all the matter in all manner, this entire issue in every other manner, legally, politically. It will be taken up in order to establish if there were such evidence that they have and sedition law that they are talking about. Remember how the sedition law has been misused in India. It was misused by the British. It is misused by the powers who control state power in our country. Now this sedition law, we will go legally also to fight it. But remember, Bhagat Singh was hanged under this sedition law. This sedition law, we will not want that to apply. So we are asking, many of those who are your deans today will remember, there was a time in this university when they arrested, not like the president today, but they arrested the other office bearers of the union, 15 of them. What was the union's response? We hijacked 15 DTC buses. We put them in the campus. And we said, by evening 5 o'clock, if our colleagues have not returned from police custody, then not only these buses, but all central government property will be destroyed on this campus. And at 5 minutes to 5, you had the police van bringing all our JNU students and releasing them unconditionally. That is the truth of the universe. I am not suggesting you do all this. But I am saying that is the strength of this university. Do not provoke the students of JNU. Otherwise, state will have to pay the price. That is why be prepared to fight this politically, fight this legally, fight this in every other form that is required. And the most important thing is your unity. The most important thing is the unity between the teachers, the students and the Karmacharis of JNU, that we are one soul. We are the soul of JNU. We are the soul of modern India today. We have to preserve this modern India from all these sort of vicious attacks. And that is why we are proud. We are proud in this campus of creating the tradition. Let 100 flags bloom. Even these sort of flags bloom. Let 100 flags bloom. Let 1,000 thoughts contend. We will discuss, we will deliberate, we will come to a solution, we will come to our understanding. That is the process through which civilizations are built. That is the process of not one university, one college, but that is the process of building a civilization. And that process which is going on in JNU, you are building the civilization of modern India. If that is going to be conquered with attack, that is something we will not tolerate and we will not accept. So be rest assured, all of us are here, many others are here to speak with you. I'd love to. And as the old timers can tell you, where I was the president was to have night-long general body meetings and people thought and accused me that we want to only talk all the while. But nevertheless, I love to spend time and share ideas with you, but there are so many others that are here. But I would only give an unsolicited advice to the union here, to the union office bearers. You must immediately convene a meeting of all the elected students' unions all over the country to come here in the defense of university autonomy. And it is through that we will be able to build and rebuild the project of a modern secular democratic India and thwart all these attempts that are finding and coming in before us in their ugly expressions. And that is why today various cross-section of leaders have come here. Very happy that they have all come here. It's wonderful to see at least in one basic parameter that on the construction and building of a modern secular democratic India, that irrespective of our political differences, we can all be united. We can all be united for that. We'll have all our differences. Well, how to build it? We'll have our differences on which way to go about, which is more important, which is less important. But on that objective of building a secular democratic modern India, there cannot be any compromise. And if they want us to compromise on that, you must emphatically say, no, this university will not accept such browbeating by the finally, you can always count on us. Coming to JNU is like coming back home to many of us, the older students. So we will be there to not only express solidarity, but to support, even materially support. So please accept God our wishes, be united, and face all such disruptions. And I wish you all the success. And this is a battle, not only confined to the campus, but this is a battle that will continue outside of